I'm here today with Nikolaos Ntavos, who is a manager and co-founder of CluBE, which is the cluster of bioeconomy and environment in Western Macedonia. Thank you for being here today, and you're involved also in the Model2Bio project. What exactly is your role in Model2Bio?
So happy to be here. Thank you, Elmar, for the interview. So as a cluster, we are dealing with trying to cooperate between companies, between SMEs and research institutes. So one of the aspects of Model2Bio is making a tool which will be vulnerable for the companies, and they will use it in order to make use of their residues.
Do you have kind of an idea, vision, what impact could this have?
The impact could be quite high because, as you know, it's a bit difficult if you are a company and you are dealing with food. Mainly, you're not aware of what you can do with the residues, and probably you don't even care. But this could be an example. This could lead them to explore the valorization of specific residues, and they will make them understand that some residues have a value.
I mean, the benefit for your cluster or for the food companies who are part of your clusters is basically in optimizing the byproduct, or you know, having a second income or having a second kind of revenue stream.
What we will try is to help them explore the possibilities of valorizing their waste streams. So this would benefit for revenues, so for new jobs that are also needed in our area. So making more circular bioeconomy in our local area in order to reduce the waste, explore and create synergies and jobs.
Can you give us a couple of examples where you say, okay, this is something that where this tool could be interesting?
For example, regarding the cheese companies, their main residue could be explored in different solutions for higher added value products, but also to, for example, to bioenergy.
And how important is the European dimension in this context?
It is very critical due to the fact that the main problem with food residues is that they are different all over Europe. So this is what we're trying to see here and what we're trying to model through the tool, to be able to explore different residues for all around Europe. So this tool will not be worth if it's going only to be used in Greece or in Spain, but it will worth if it could be used in Holland, in Belgium, and in all the rest of the European continents.
Okay, well, let's hope that we're going to have some results in the coming months, years. I don't know how long it will take.
Coming months, I think.
Coming months? Okay, very good. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much. And that was Nikolaos Ntavos from CluBE.
Thank you.